is really getting screwed in all this is Bill Clinton. Because basically, she's like, hey, listen, I'm going to take the children to go see mom for about 2 weeks this summer. Do you mind? No, I got plenty of work to do. I'll take care of some yard work or whatever. And then times that by a lifetime. And all of a sudden, the last day, you got the poker party set up. You got bowling night every night. You're ready to go. You're taking a week off vacation. There's no doubt. And then you find out, honey, I decided to stay home. And you're like, what?
No.
Come on.
This could be a whole new phase of their life.
That's what I'm saying. Bill Clinton, I mean, think about the traveling on the fun he's had.
But you asked me how many times.
Think they're going to make love 5 times between now and the end of the year?
Depends how you define make love.
They do it last night?
No. Probably a warm embrace.
Trump and Melania, how many times between now and the end of the year? See, I get this feeling they don't do it at all.
No.
Am I wrong here?
Yes.
She's fantastic. He's a nice looking guy, but I just get this feeling. Yeah. He's probably like, don't touch me. You're going to mess my hair up.
He's that way. You don't think she's that way?
Maybe a little bit of both.
Yeah.
They may be living glass bubbles. Five times for Bill and Hillary. How many times for Donald?
So maybe slightly. It's 5 ± 2 on Bill or Hillary. Bill and Hillary.
Yeah.
And Donald, Donald's probably about 3. It's going to be busy.
Top or bottom for Donald?
I can't do it, dude. I'm saturated.
I mean, you want to talk about politics? We're talking politics.
Okay. I don't. Bottom.
All right.
Okay, now I must leave now.
He's the relationship expert.
He was vomiting.
Dr. Josh Klapo, UAB clinical psychologist. God. He's been there, done that. Men's Health, CNN, CBS Nightly News, NBC Nightly News, every major network. You were on every major network with the exception of CBS today, right?
Locally.
CBS 42 is the only one we've had in the studio, so they probably had enough of
you. I don't know. They're probably sick of me. No, we did ABC, NBC, Fox, and our show was quoted in Bustle.com.
I saw that. I retweeted that. It's awesome.
And it should be coming out today. I didn't have a chance to look. We're in BuzzFeed as well, is reached out to us, because people are very interested in relationship shows or people who deal in relationships and what people are feeling about the election and how it's affecting intimate relationships, which we covered, before the debates?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So we've already covered it.
We're already done.
So now they reach out and they're asking, does anyone do that? Oh, yeah, well, we do that all the time.
Now, if your plane ever gets too full, you know, you can push some of these interviews my way.
Well, we're going to do one tonight locally.
I know. You are the relationship expert. People are like, what is Tony Curry doing on this show? Of course, I do Jocks 94.5 and do a morning show with Alan Jay. I am not a relationship expert, per se, in that field, but I am a expert in telling people like it is.
Yes.
If you have a gut feeling and you're like, yeah, the guy's been beating me for years and for whatever reason, I'll be the one to say, firebomb the house and leave.
Right.
I'll tell people things they don't want to hear, but they know they need to hear.
And then I'll tell it to them again in a way that they can hear it.
Exactly. You saw it.
That's all it makes a good team.
Laurel Taylor's also in the studio tonight. Laurel's Lifestyle is coming up here shortly. I'm all about interesting and different. And so everyone's wanting to leave and go to Canada. This worked out great because we have a special guest who's going to join us in about 6 or 7 minutes from Niagara Falls, Canada. This gentleman is an award-winning ex-executive producer, award-winning lecturer. He's written books. He's got his own radio show called Mental Health Matters.
Mm-hmm.
And he's also got one of the most successful Canadian television shows called Niagara Falls Haunted. And he'll join the show in just a few minutes.
And he's a psychologist.
Do you feel threatened?
No, I got something to aspire to.
All right, I'm going to throw out a letter that I received on Wednesday in the mail here from Cumulus. And we only have a few minutes here before we have to hit this break, and then we'll continue it, because I think this letter is going to touch a lot of people. Dear Tony, listen to the web every Tuesday, Wednesday night, love the show, blah, 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 blah. I'm 55, been happily married for 22 years, have 2 beautiful children, and I'm blessed. But recently, while surfing Facebook, here we go.
Oh, boy.
Found the woman I dated back in college. She was my first love and my first dump. I had never been dumped before until this woman, and I haven't been dumped since. Evidently, it hurt, I guess, when it happened.
It sounds like
Not thinking of her for years, I've thought about her in passing, and occasionally even have dreams about her, always dismissing the thoughts as passive or flights. We've reached out to each other several times since he got on Facebook. Always clean and short, not flirtatious. But then last Wednesday, I saw a pic of her showing off her new engagement ring.
Uh-oh.
She's 54, never been married, and it hurt. I don't know why. I really have no feelings for her. I'm happy with my relationship and I'm happy for her, but I can't stop thinking about her. Am I in trouble? Signed, blah, 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 blah.
Yeah. Oh my God, there's so many cheesy love songs. They just go to, can't remember the artist, What Might Have Been.
Yep.
The Dan Fogelberg song.
Yep. Longer?
No, not that one.
Run for the Roses.
No. The New Year's All.
All Lang Syne.
Yeah.
Been in the grocery store, six pack of beer,
The years have been kinder.
Pina Colada song?
No. It makes total sense.
All right, so what's happening there?
What do you want me to tell you now? I can tell you in a minute.
You know what? Let's we got a guest coming up here in a second. Let's go ahead and pick it up at 7:30 because I think we're going to go a little bit on this.
It is very powerful.
On the same note, on Thursday, I got a wedding invitation from a friend of mine in Cincinnati who is getting married for his third time to the same woman.
Okay, that's...
Third time to the same woman. And the first two divorces were as messy and as sloppy as any divorce could go. Fell in love in college, blew it out, had a kid, just totally exploded. They just went after each other's throats with lawyers. Got back together again, said, what are we doing? This is crazy. Maybe matured a little bit. 6 years later, get married again. Broke up 5 years later, and now they're getting married a third time.
Oh, my God. He's got to call the show.
But one of the reasons, and I haven't spoken to him, but he was a college friend of mine. We always talked about, you break up with a woman, and your friends are like, dude, she was smoking hot. What were you thinking? You're like, hey, listen, live with her you don't even know what, but they're like, hey, listen, I don't care how bad it is. Look at that. I mean, can't you get past it, okay? And that's very shallow. I get that. But when you do break up with somebody and you haven't seen them for a while, it's safe because you know each other very well and you're very comfortable with each other. And what do you usually remember? Only the good things, right?
Yes.
You don't remember why you hated her. You don't remember why you broke up. You only remember the great sex. You only remember the great dates. You remember the great walks. You remember the bottle of wine you drank and while you're looking over the mountain with it. All those things, you get back together again, then you realize this is why it didn't work out. Well, this particular time, they're getting together for the third time. So we'll talk about nostalgia as well.
Yeah, and I want to tell you about an email that I got, a question about, should I sleep with my ex? I totally forgot.
And you said yes, of course.
No. Depends.
This is going to be
great. I'll tell you what I respond.
All right, 545-9950, 844-455-9950, at the web, 995, on Twitter, thewebradioshow.com. You can stream us anytime, great website, and it continually is updated. And again, if you make a phone call tonight, we've already got some people chiming in. We try to get your phone calls on as quickly as possible. We have an underlying current of what we talk about here on the web, but you don't have to talk about that. I know politics are huge right now. People still want to talk about the election. If you want to call and talk about that, We'll look into that as well.
Hey, look, there's a lot of passion, there's a lot of heartache right now, and that may be in your personal relationship or that may be in your political relationship. But remind me to tell you about the question about sleeping with your ex.
My ex?
No, not me sleeping with your ex.
That'd be a great show. Host of Niagara's Most Haunted, one of Canada's most popular shows. He's got a radio show called Mental Health Matters, and he's an award-winning executive producer. He is from Canada. He's in Canada right now at Niagara Falls. We talk to him next right here on the web.
Let me go get her.
Opened up.
Bye, guys. Until next segment.
I did. I got a question about Chesley.